Hi, this is Stelios from the TESSERACT Academy, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about natural language processing. I'm going to walk you through a quick overview of the field, and we're also going to be talking about some really cool applications for businesses. The first thing we need to do is to ask, what is natural language processing? So Wikipedia defines natural language processing as an area of computer science and artificial intelligence that is concerned with the interaction between computers and human, that is, natural languages. In particular, what interests us in this area of expertise is how to program computers to be able to process and analyze large amounts of natural language data. And talking about classifiers, one of the most common use cases of natural language processing is text classification. Okay, probably the most famous one is sentiment analysis. It's something that most people are familiar with. So sentiment analysis refers to extracting a score for the emotional content of a piece of text. Traditionally, this has been two classes, like positive or negative, or three classes, positive, negative, neutral. It's very easy to see why this is so powerful, things such as market research. So a company might release a new product, and they want to see what the user feedback is like for this product. So instead of just running a survey, they can go to forums, they can go to social media and extract comments about this product and see what the people are talking about. This is much more cost efficient and faster than running a survey. However, text classification is used in other contexts as well. A very common context is understanding whether an email is spam or not, or categorizing emails into, for example, categories such as offers or important emails or emails from social media. And this can also extend to other things as well. For example, Facebook, it breaks down every comment basically on Facebook is not treated as a single comment. There's this thing called intent analysis, which basically tries to understand what was the intent behind a comment, right? So you can see, for example, on this pie chart, which concerns Facebook comments, that around half of the comments refer to opinions, but you also can have about marketing, random comments or spam or complaints. This pie chart is from an analysis of Facebook comments of a particular group. Summarization is an interesting use case of natural language processing, and the goal of summarization is to effectively take a large chunk of text and shorten it. It's a very simple idea. Obviously, you can apply this to also sentences or paragraphs. Why you want to do this? Well, you want to do this because you want to help humans consume content faster. So if you're one of those people whose job really depends on consuming content faster, be it a researcher or a journalist or a writer, etc., summarization can be a very useful tool which lets you crawl faster research articles, news articles, etc. Named entity recognition is a very powerful application of natural language processing. And what named entity recognition is about, it's about understanding whether particular words in a piece of text refer to entities in the real world, being people or organizations or locations or time, days of the year, whatever. It's very easy to see why this is such a powerful application. First of all, it can help with classification, all right? So you can use the information extracted from name entity recognition in order to classify better news stories, for example. And it can also be used in order to improve content search. So coming back again to the example of, let's say, a researcher or a journalist, someone who has to consume lots of content, by running name entity recognition in news articles or research papers, you can very quickly extract the entities that exist in those articles and then use these as tags. So when someone wants to search through all these articles, they can just type, let's say, one or two tags and then can see all the documents where this entity exists. The important thing about name entity recognition is that it doesn't just extract the name of an entity, because, I mean, it's not like you have a list of, let's say, names and then, you know, just there's a simple search and it's like, hey, you know, I saw this name there. It can operate in a smarter way, so it can understand whether an entity exists in a text, even if it's not always directly mentioned in a sense. So this is what makes it really powerful. And it can also be used in recommendations. Again, similar problem to classification. Name entity recognition can help you extract this useful information and then use it to, for example, recommend similar news articles to what someone likes. It can also be used in customer support, right? So you want your system, for example, to understand whether, let's say you're a retailer, you have multiple branches across the world, you want to understand what someone's referring to, whether they're referring to a particular product or a particular shop in a location, etc. Another powerful application of natural language processing is text generation. So this is probably the single coolest application of natural language processing. However, I might say it's the most immature in a sense because it's just not there yet. This application came about mainly through the use of deep neural networks. So using a deep neural network, it's possible to basically feed it lots of text from a particular writer, and then the network can start producing text speaking in a similar manner. In this case, this network speaks like a Shakespeare tragedy. You can see why generating content using a machine learning algorithm can be such a great idea. The end goal is to be able to feed some articles into a network, tune a few parameters, and then the network could come up with articles on its own. This is a content marketer's dream come true. However, it's very difficult. I mean, it's pretty cool, but there are issues, and the syntax and everything is right, and this looks as if it's written by a human, but most of the time it doesn't make much sense, especially when you want the deep neural networks to produce larger pieces of text. Still, this technology is advancing, so probably sooner or later we're gonna see it being used more and more often. And finally, another application, I wouldn't say application, it's mostly, let's say, one of the things that, one of the methods that came out of natural language processing, which is very interesting, probably not directly applicable to businesses, but it's still so cool that I felt it's very important to mention it, is Word2Vec. Word2Vec was discovered a few years ago, and it's basically a way for machines to understand language a bit like the way we do. So using Word2Vec, it's possible to create a model that can understand relationships between words, and these relationships to a large extent are similar to the relationships that we are using. It makes sense. So for example, the network can understand that king is to man what queen is to woman, and we can perform mathematical operations such as addition and subtraction of those vectors and manipulate these concepts in the model's, let's say, brain. So you can see this male to female analogy on the left, and you can see in the middle that the model, the neural network in this case, can also understand tenses, right? So it can understand that walking is the same distance to walk, to swimming, to swim. And similarly, it can also understand relationships between countries and capitals. This technology is very powerful. It's used in machine translation. It's also being used in pretty much anything that involves deep neural networks and natural language processing, since it can dramatically improve performance. Unless you're a data scientist yourself, probably this might be a bit difficult to understand, but I thought it's good to mention this because it can show you the capabilities of the current state of the art in natural language processing and where we're going to. Finally, natural language processing is also, it's basically being used in consumer products all the time, even if you don't realize it. For example, Alexa, voice interfaces. So this is natural language processing, speech understanding, and also voice generation. Okay, so this is pure natural language processing. And also chatbots, right? So this is another popular application of natural language processing. And chatbots, I'd say it's not so much a single application, faces and all these devices. It's actually many applications stacked together and combined to form a single product. So that was it from me. That was a very quick overview of natural language processing. I hope that now you have a better idea of what natural language processing is about. It's a huge field, all right? So there are people that dedicate their whole careers to this field, and it's rapidly advancing. So we can do many amazing things with natural language processing, from sentiment analysis to text generation, but there are still more and more use cases coming. So if you believe that this field is relevant to your business, then stay tuned. Ask, research, look into it, because it's likely that there's a really useful, cool use case out there which can help you, and you might not know it. So this was Stelios from TESSERACT Academy. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you soon in some other of our videos. Thank you. Bye.